Welcome to CrossYoga Restorative. My name is Ria. I'm the founder of CrossYoga and the host of this channel. Restorative yoga is a very, very calming yoga practice. It's really amazing if you feel stressed or just need to relax really deeply. We don't move a whole lot. Actually, through this class, we'll only encounter 4-5 different poses, and we'll stay in each pose for as much as 10 minutes. To get into all these relaxing poses, it's quite important that you have some equipment. Now, it's not certain that you have blocks, but maybe you have something. If not, books or pots and pans, whatever works for you. This is called a bolster, and it's quite heavy, actually, but it's really amazing and kind of soft, nice to be resting on. If you don't have this, maybe pillows from the couch or your bed or something like that to replace this. Least but not last, maybe blankets, whatever you have. So something like that, and I'll show you how to put it all up, and then you will have to figure out how to do that on your own. You have to be resting really comfortably so you don't move, and if you are somewhere where it might be a little bit chilly or a little breeze coming in, you might want to get the right kind of clothes on so you don't get cold. Before we start, I would like to invite you into a prayer. So just sit wherever you are. Close your eyes. Inhale and exhale. God, thank you that you call us also to rest. I pray that you'll fill up our maybe empty jaws right now. Help us to know that we are loved, seen, approved, even though we're doing nothing. Just resting, breathing. All in relationship with you. Never alone. Help us open up our hearts. Help us release and let go what you see doesn't serve us and our mission in life. In your name, Jesus, amen. Now first we're gonna lay down. So you need to gather your blocks, put one on the highest and one on the lowest. Now it might take some time to get all this stacked the right way, but let's see. We're gonna rest on this kind of cushion here. It's not the same as resting in the couch, so don't mistake that. Now this blanket you can choose to put underneath your lower back here or under your head or something like that. So it can be stacked under here to support. I like this. Your back a little more. And here we go. Coming down on your back and rest. Now my band here, hip band is a little bit in the way, so take your time. When you feel settled and supported, you can take your hands out to the side and open up your chest. And maybe even having bolsters underneath your arms is really nice. Close your eyes gently. And this is it. You are welcome to have music if you like. But maybe just stay with the quietness. And maybe with the image that God loves his wings, supporting you like a baby bird in the nest is covered and supported by the wings of the mom.
or the dad.
Picture yourself as calm and safe in the nest. slowly bring your awareness back to your breath. Maybe sigh it out. Gently open your eyes, wriggling fingers and toes, ankles and wrists. And slowly come into a seated position. And try to move as slowly as you can. Next pose is a forward fold, wide-legged forward fold. So we're gonna use our equipment in another way. Maybe you wanna sit on the blanket to support your sitting bones. But sit with your legs out to the side. Bring your bolster or whatever you have. Again, you can stack your blocks low or high depending on where your spine and stuff is. You can just be creative with how you plant your blocks. Put your bolster here because this is maybe a little bit low for me. And now remember, we don't want to go for a deep stretch. We just want to relax. Don't try to be effective here. So somewhere where you support it so that your forehead can reach whatever you have going on here. So take your arms, maybe holding it, maybe taking it down. You're welcome to move your arms, whatever makes sense to you. Make sure your quads and legs are relaxed. So don't put them out so wide that you feel like you can't relax and stay here. Forehead relaxes on the system you have built. And maybe during this time, lean in as you lean your head, maybe your body as well, into God's promises. Maybe his promise of restoration, his promise of healing, or his promise that he has not forgotten you.
prepare yourself to get out of this pose. Try to move slowly.
And do whatever feels nice to reset. The next pose will be supported child's pose. So again, we're gonna build our bolster block system here. There's really no right or wrong way to build your supportive system here, so just get as much support as you can and whatever feels good in your body. We're all different. Some have long legs, some have more bigger chest, and some have sore knees. So I'll show you what we're gonna do, and then maybe you will take your time to kind of support yourself. I think I'm gonna lower this down anyway. So you're just gonna lean over, and maybe you put this bolster even further down underneath your hip. Put your arms wherever it feels good. Make sure your chest rests on the system you've built here. Take one ear out to the bolster and one out to the side. So you're resting on one side of the head. I'm gonna switch side in a few minutes. And maybe you feel your breath. If you are supported on your lungs and your belly. Inhale slow. And exhale slowly. Let go of any tension you might have in your head or your neck, your shoulders.
Lift your head and gently move your head to the other side for neck stretch in the other direction. Prepare yourself for releasing from this pose. Maybe you come up on all fours, stretching out one leg behind you, and opposite side. Again, we're gonna lay down and rest, this time on our side, kind of support fetus pose. So we'll take the bolster in between our legs to support. If your ankles doesn't like being on somewhat hard floor, again, blankets underneath there, and maybe even an extra blanket behind your back. You can also choose to use a block put behind your back. This is also a really nice pose if you're pregnant, just to rest on your side. Now, you can either come down just like this and put your hands underneath your head. This is not good for my neck, so I would rather have a kind of a pillow stacked with a bolster or just the blanket or whatever makes sense. So take your time, come down on your side, knees somewhat 90 degree angles. And this might be difficult not to fall asleep. And you're welcome to as well, but try to stay with your breath and notice the sensations in your body as you close your eyes and relax. Again, open your eyes. Take your top arm, whatever arm that might be, and slowly push through and come into seated position. Of course, we're going to do exactly this pose on the other side. So just take whatever you have with you, move to the other side. And maybe this side will be different than the other side, so don't worry about that. Just support yourself as you like. Try to avoid moving or fidgeting with things and hair and stuff like that when you're down there. As you move into your last pose, relax your body. Notice that you breathe and try to stay with your breath. Take a huge inhale. Sigh it out. And again, move into seated pose ever so slowly.
Again, you can close your eyes just for a second. Notice how your body feels. And maybe you need to say thank you to God for taking this time to relax. Remind yourself that this is important. Rest as well as work go hand in hand. And even Jesus knew that as he retreated many times back in the mountains to pray when he was tired. Thank you so much for joining me today. May God's peace live in your body, soul, and mind. Thank you.